I'll never forget where I was when I heard that Lord British had been killed. The character, Ultima creator Richard Garriott's alter ego and Ingham Avatar, burned to a crisp during a beta test of Ultima Online on August 9, 1997. The game officially launched a month and a half later, 20 years ago today, and I loved it in a way that has kept me from loving any massively multiplayer RPG released since. It might not look like much now, but back then it looked like the future, and I could only imagine the kind of worlds I'd be building in alternate online life in 20 years down the line. I can still only imagine them, because the spirit of Ultima Online, at least what it meant to me, seemed to wither on the vine. Trama was my favorite place. Until the Renaissance expansion which brought it into existence, I'd been playing in Valukka, which was a den of thieves and killers. The new land, Trama, mirrored Valukka geographically, but it was an altogether different place in terms of social niceties. Simply put, players couldn't kill one another, unless they'd agreed to do so. That lent the world a chivalric sense, and made Ultima a place of virtue, as I felt it should be, where combat was more likely to take the form of a polite, if fatal duel, rather than a brutal assault. I built a house, and I met people who became friends. In World of Warcraft, The Secret World and Guild Wars, the only other MMOs I've spent more than a few hours with, I leveled up and quested, and killed all manner of monsters. In Ultima Online, I existed. It shaped my notion of what an online world should be, in the same way that Ultima Vice shaped my notion of what an RPG world should. Fundamentally, I wanted the ordinary to sit side by side with the extraordinary, which meant that buying a house not quite as fantastical a concept in 1997 as in 2017 was as exciting as hunting monsters. The appeal is summarized beautifully by Player Petrified in our 2015 revisit and retrospective Ultima Endures, because it is diverse, appealing to many different people with many different play types and makes no demands. Basically, you do what you want, when you want, if you want. You don't have to commit to hours online while undertaking a raid. You can log in for 10 minutes and still feel you've achieved something. It endures because players have ownership of property, they have houses which they have built and furnished, they live in UO. There's a sense of presence here. You should also read about Alex's adventures as UO's worst ninja. And where was I when I heard that Lord British had been killed? I was online, at a friend's house, hardly able to believe that the creator of a game could be killed by a player within that game. It was science fiction. It was also the result of a rebooted server, oversights on the developer end and problems with lag, but I can't remember being so immediately sold on the idea of a game as when I heard that Lord British had been assassinated during a public address. 20 years later, I still wish I'd been right there in the world to see it happen.